What's good, you guys? Welcome to another brand new episode of Rendezvous with Yash Chauhan. Today we have with us Mr. Akash Ranasan, all the way from Indore. So it's an honor to have you on here. He has been someone whom I have looked up to in the recent months when I heard about him from another friend of mine. And as it turns out, he is also from Indore, where I've stayed for quite some time. So starting off, Akash, first of all, thanks a lot for being here, man. It really means a lot.
Thank you so much for calling me. That means a lot too.
Sure, man. Okay, first of all, Akash, just for a bit of context for our audience, could you please tell us a bit about yourself?
So, I'm usually known for two things. One is a responsible traveler. Second is a climate change activist. Mm. These are the things I've been doing for the last 6 years. And yeah, that's me in short.
Well, great. So, what do you mean when you say that you're a responsible traveler? Like, what's the difference between a normal traveler and a responsible traveler?
So, normal traveler is just any other person who's traveling around because he feels like that, hey, I want to travel, it makes me happy. For me, it's surely the same feeling, but with a plus one, that hey, I want to travel, I want to go to places, but want to make sure at the same point of time that my travel is not really causing harm to climate and to environment, right?
Understood.
So taking in account and taking care of it, that how much of carbon I'm producing, how much of methane.
So being environmentally conscious, you would say. Understood, bro. Understood. So you also said that you are a climate activist. So how has that been for you? Like, when did that thing start? When did you realize ki, okay, there is something that we as a generation need to do? And what are the steps that you have taken for that?
So it's very simple. It's all started because of travel only, that I have been going to places. And when I went to different places, let's say simple example, Ladakh, I went over there a year and I liked it. And the next year I again went over there and I didn't really feel the same. And the reason I realized that there are a lot of people coming there every day, every year, and they are littering it, right? Mm. And also our construction is going on. So we are killing the real Ladakh and we are building another one. So the tourists can come over there. They can have a different life experience over there. And in a way, we are literally spoiling the environment. So that's when I realized, hey, as a traveler, I need to take care of my side and do as much as I can do from mine.
Understood. Got that, bro. So where did this bug of traveling come from? Like, were you very, kind of adventurous as a kid? Or, like, where did this thing start?
So it's I never thought that I'm going to be a traveler. It was never thought that I'm going to be doing something like this. It's very simple that I wanted to cycle. 2014, I could start cycling. And when I cycled, the first trip I did was from Madhya Pradesh to Mumbai and back to India on a cycle.
Wow.
And that's when I got into cycling. Like, I've been cycling before that too, like for 3-5 months. I July to December. So from July to till December, I kept cycling on my own to, let's say, places around the city. I kept going to some waterfalls, some hilltop and dam, these kind of places. On December, I did this from Indore to Mumbai and back to Indore. And that's when I realized that, hey, I really want to do more of this long tours on cycle. And from there, I started more cycling to different cities, states, and countries on a cycle. And that's when this started. Slowly from cycle, it became to travel.
Got it, bro. Got it. So, like, how were you as a kid? Like, were you the kind of the quiet kid who used to, like, you know, mind his own business? Or were you the extroverted kid who would always go out of his way and, like, you know, talk to people? Like, what was your mindset back then?
So, for me, it was more of that I was a bullied kid. I was not really out there telling my own things. I was always scared. And so that was me. Not really the guy who would go out and do things the way he want. I would always be scared to do anything, think a lot about it. I would fail in everything I would do. So yeah, that's me.
Got it. So how did that transition happen from that introverted, bullied, scared kid to the person you are right now, having given so many TED Talks and worked with Forbes and GoPro and the likes of others?
So how it happened, I think it goes to this like one quotation which can explain you. In order to shoot an arrow, it's important to pull it back.
Yeah.
That's what happened. And Swami Vivekananda, right? I read because of everything happened. He gave me all the knowledge, all the quotations, which became the strength and gave me the guidance on how can I do things.
Got it, bro. Got it. So would you say that Swami Vivekananda has influenced your life in a very big way?
100% total. If he is not there, I'm not here today with you.
Okay, wow. Really. So how did you get introduced to Swami Vivekananda?
What happened that I was in school, I was in 9th class, and I was not really the cool kid, again, as I told you, right? I was not bullied. And I really wanted to have friends in that school. But since we already a few months have passed, like 3, 4, 5, 6, I don't know how many months have passed, but I do not have friends in this school. And, you know, it can get really difficult for a kid to be in a school like this and where you do not have friends. Wherein I see the other people, other kids in the school, they have been studying from the nursery class in this school itself.
Yeah.
They are like super close. They live nearby. They know everything almost about each other. They know their nicknames. They meet after school, wherein I'm like the left behind. So I was always looking for ways that how can I be friends with these kids? What can I do to be the part of the group? And I was one day and I found a tiny book, this tinier book, in this site. Right? And this book is of quotation, right? And I thought, hey, it's a very fancy book. If I can take this book to school, kids will get attracted. And they will talk to me. So it was not my book. It belonged to my Masi, right? And she recently came back from Bangalore, so she bought this book.
Okay.
And I stole it. I did not tell her, because if I would, she won't let me do that, because she knows that I'm a kid. I might tear it apart or do something with it. So I stole it. I took it to the school, opened it in the restrooms, and started pretending that I'm reading it so that other people will see and come and talk to me, as in other kids. Nobody came. I was kept reading it, and the restrooms got over, and I continued with the simple life. But a lot of people came in that restroom, right? Because I read the book. The book was filled with a lot of quotations. You are a hero. Right? Fear is death. Arise, awake, stop not until the goal is achieved.
Yeah.
Take up an idea, make it in your life, die for it, ask your every now and self to work for it, and that's the only way to success. Anything which makes you weak, physically, intellectually, mentally, reflect it as poison.
Got it.
Right? Whatever we are, the result of what we have thought. So all of these, and I'm like, okay, cool. So, and from there, Slowly, it started getting into my brain. I started acting upon these things, because this was the only thing which was giving me strength.
Yeah.
This was the person. These were the only lines I can read, the only person I can read, the only thing I can find which was in my support, which was telling me that I can be strong. Every other thing, bullying me or pitying me, telling me that I'm not good at studies, I'm not good at this, I'm not good at that, I don't do anything right. This was the only one telling me that, hey, I can do anything, I'm a hero. Right? Yeah. I have no fear. So that's why
I got attracted to that positivity.
Exactly. So I didn't really plan it intentionally that I need to do this. This started giving me so much energy that automatically I went back to it. Right? You don't have to do it consciously. If you just feel for something or someone, you just keep going back to them. So that's how patience really worked out for me. And from then on, I kept reading more and more about Swami Vivekananda. Whichever city I go, if I know there is a Ramakrishna Math, I would go over there. I would buy more and more books. I would just randomly buy 30, 40, 50 books and gift it to all the people I know. Right?
Wow.
10, 20 rupees, 15 rupees. And they're full of quotations. Right, but these quotations cost like what? Not
they're priceless.
Right, it can give you amazing life. Yeah. So I would buy books like in bunch and then start giving it one on one whomsoever I need. I will just give it. Right, then you need it.
That's great, bro. That's great. So, like, you know, I relate a lot with this story, because even I have the same kind of an upbringing, where even like my dad is in a government job, so he used to shift around a lot. So I remember when I was 9 years old, my dad got transferred to Kenya in Africa. And when I went there, that was a whole another kind of a leap for me, because like usually it was just that the people were different. Here, the culture, the people, the language, the accent, everything was different. So it was really hard for me to adjust over there. But again, books became my salvation. And that's where I would like, that's where I got the habit of reading. And I definitely understand that, you know, how you find that comfort in a book and you find that confidence there. And that's what builds up over time. That's what I believe. So the next question I'd like to ask you is that how did your family take the news of you traveling? And like we had an earlier conversation where you said that you didn't have the ideal childhood. So what was that like and how did you deal with that?
So answering the first one, if I take it, my family is just me and my mom. Right? And the only thing she had that she did not align with is the security on road, right? That if I go cycling here and there, it's not really safe, right? I can get hit by a bike or a car or any vehicle can come and hit me and I'll be dead. That's the only insecurity. That's the only thing she had in mind, that do whatever you want in life. Live your life that you like. Live the way you want. Be happy. But don't just put yourself in risk, right?
So there was that the maternal fear was there, but she was like, you can take whatever career path you want. I don't have an issue with it.
Exactly. That was not a problem with me. The only thing was that, hey, it's not safe being on road cycling from Indore to Mumbai. Obviously, these roads are full of trucks, buses, and we know that how people drive in India from on highway. It's not safe. And Indore to Mumbai will be like 4 to 5 nights in between. Where will I stay over there? What will happen? People are not out there, let's say, on a highway, she would think. And that's why she was really concerned as a mother. Your safety and security, that was the only thing. But then I said one thing very clearly, that hey, this is my dream, I want to do it, I'm going to do it. Find me one thing I've done. If you tell me one mistake, I won't do this. And she couldn't come back to me. One mistake I would have made. And I just went ahead.
Got it, bro. Got it. So, like, how did you actually like manage? So, let's say you're going from Indore to Mumbai. So, like you said, that's a 4 or 5 night journey, like by cycle. So, where would you stay at night? Like, would you plan those trips beforehand so like you would have pit stops for every day? By like, let's say tonight I need to reach at this dhaba or this motel. How would that work out?
No, so there's no planning at all. All you know is your start point and your end point. That's it.
Except so that's all you plan.
Except this, you do not know anything, because I would travel without money. I won't have much of money in my hand. Okay. So I can't afford to sleep in a hotel, right? I would just go and find a place that evening only, that okay, now where can I sleep, right? So that's end moment call, that I have to figure out a place, ask someone that, hey, can you help me like that, right?
So like frugal living kind of thing.
Yeah, so I would start morning, let's say somewhere about, I would wake up 5. By 5:30, I'll be on the saddle. I'll start cycling. And I'll cycle till, let's say, 10 about. From 5:30, I'll start. I'll cycle till 10 a.m. nonstop. And because I know that this is the time where I need to cover the most distance of the day. Because by 10, sunlight will be there right on my head, right?
Yeah.
And then it won't be that much of, like, it won't be that easy to cycle this much.
Yeah.
So that
the sunlight would cause a problem.
Exactly. And it'll go double the energy for the same distance. Right? Obviously, if you do things like you start early and you achieve something good by this time, you start to feel good.
Yeah, the momentum kicks in.
Yes, and you already know that, okay, the bigger part I have already done. Now the remaining day, slowly make it happen and do it.
Got it.
That's what I would do. And by 10, I would stop and then have I would call it first lunch. I wouldn't call it a break. I would call it the first lunch because I would eat a heavy lunch. I need real-time food, which is going to be very heavy.
You need the carbs for definitely that kind of work.
Because I push a lot throughout the day, so I can't call it a breakfast. And also the other thing, the only money I would carry for this, because food I can't compromise on it.
Yeah.
It's the only thing, right? And I know that if I ask for food, I would get such a food which I need for this. Right? The only money I would carry was for food. So yeah, I'll have amazing lunch. And then I'll start, the first lunch. Then I'll start cycling again about 10. And I would cycle till 1, 1:30 or 2.
Okay.
Right? And then I'll have lunch the second time. And then again, I'll start, right, after the lunch. And I would then cycle till 30 to 6.
Okay.
5:30. Then I know that, okay, now the sun is down. I need to start looking around it where I can find a place to stay tonight.
So for the you would like cycle in three shifts.
Yeah.
Right? Got it.
So I would find places like Toll Naka, petrol pump, Gurudwara.
Oh, that kind of a thing. Got it. Oh, damn, that's fascinating, bro. So like, how, like, that's just totally like crazy. I would love to experience that someday. For sure. That's awesome, bro.
Yeah, so then I would stay in these kind of places or unknown house in a village. And then again, talk to them, share stories, listen to their stories, eat something and meet their friends, right? And they would take photos with me. That's so cool. They would take photos with my cycle. Like, oh, this is a really cool cycle. And then, yeah, so morning will happen. And again, I'll sleep by, let's say, 8:30 or 10 max. Anyhow, I'll be sleeping.
Yeah, because you need to get up early. So, like, one cross question to this would be, you said that your mom was very supportive of this decision. But what advice would you give to, you know, fellow youngsters who want to do something like this, but their families are like, you know, kind of reluctant to do something, do things. Okay.
People will, parents will let you do anything and everything. It's just they don't trust you.
So how do you get them to trust you?
Good things. Make good decisions. What do you do in college is shit. You want to spend money. You don't want to focus on yourself. You don't want to make any mature decision, right? You want to watch movies, watch series, meet friends, chill out. There is no focus. How do you, like, why would I trust you? Give me one reason. Why do I trust? What are you doing? Are you taking any step in life?
Got it.
Are you coming, hey, I did this thing. I started a project on my own and I decided to help a guy who wanted to study computer. His fees was, let's say, 5,000 rupees. So I started collecting this 5,000 rupees from friends and everyone. I'm helping this guy. You are not doing one mature thing. Why would your parents really trust you? You're just a school kid.
So you need to take the initiative and get them to trust you before you get something.
I would give you a job. Even if I give you a job, even after you being in college 4 years, 5 years, you are for a trainee. I don't let you handle things.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Why do I trust you? How do I trust you? So 2014, when I was doing this cycling trip, before doing this trip, I organized the cyclothon.
Okay.
In that 800 people cycled.
Okay, wow.
More than 200 policemen were on road to make sure that the cyclothon is going right. I could the city police team to get on road that morning and make sure that this event happened successfully. Right? I could convince a government university to lend me their property for that one day so that I can organize the event on.
Wow.
Right? Lend Denny Oscar and my FM to be my media partner and talk about this event on the front page of their newspaper and on the prime time of the radio channel.
Wow. Right? Okay, got it.
PI Cycles of India, which owns these brands called PSA and Hercules, right? Which are to come on board and be the title sponsor of this event.
Got it.
Right? I can convince a company to put more than 20 holdings in this city. On the name of cyclothon and no money paid.
Wow.
Right? When the event ended, I was 1.8 lakh rupees down. Okay. I had a loss. Right? I hid it while in college. What did you do? Like, you took money from parents.
Understood.
I was 1.8 lakh rupees down. I paid it back and then I was at zero back again.
Got it. So it's about taking that initiative and like making your parents believe ki haan ye bachcha khud kuch karna chahta hai.
See, that's what I'm saying. Unko lagta hai bachcha hai. So obviously bachche se aap bachche se sab ye karte ho. Right? That's what you do. And you feel like, hey, you take initiative. You are out there dealing with people, communicating with people, making things happen. Right?
Until
it doesn't work that way, right? You need to start taking marketing initiative, you need to show that, yes, I can do things, I can take good decisions. And then only your parents will trust you. That, okay, cool. Because my mom was concerned about my health and safety. That's it. Not that I can't deal with people or anything like that. It's the safety. You will be safe on the road.
That's what she was worried about.
Recently, even if you go today and then tell them that, hey, I want to do something of 50,000 rupees, can you lend me money? They can't.
Yeah, got it. So how did you start like bootstrapping your way through this? Because like, even if you're cycling from Indore to, let's say, Mumbai, you wouldn't be able to like, okay, you can maybe go on a normal cycle, but that would be a lot more tiring. So I would be, considering that you'd be having a proper cycle, which costs quite a bit of money. And like, also like the camera you use right now and like your whole setup and your gear, all that costs a lot of money. And like you said, you didn't really take money from your family. So how did you bootstrap through that whole process?
So how I did it is, I was in eighth class. Mm-hmm. I crossed eight, and I asked my mom that I want to go and join this spoken English classes.
Okay.
Because my name, she said, okay, I'll arrange the money. She let me go there, and on this spoken English classes, they gave a free 3 months computer learning course, computer basic course. And that was the like kind of the first kind of a time when I'm really getting to use a computer, because in school what all we learn on a computer.
Yeah.
Like, so that was the first time when I was really using a computer properly. And so what happened, it's a funny scene a little. So after this class and everything was done, my friend took me to a, and this is the first time when I'm going to a cyber cafe as well.
Okay.
He's the one to a cyber cafe. And I'm like this no brain guy. I don't know anything. How does it work? Like, I'm now understanding that whether to just click the button on CPU, whether to keep it and press it and then leave it. I'm that confused.
Yeah. So like you're totally blank about it.
Yes. And this guy knows a little of things. So he starts with PC. He opens my Internet Explorer and he write down the few things over there, and the search results comes, and I'm like, oh shit. And I'm awkward. I'm like, shit. And he's just sitting right next to me, and on the screen, it's Spawn.
Oh, damn.
And I'm like, what is this? Like, I haven't seen that kind of a thing in life.
Yeah.
And I'm a super shy kid. And I'm so shy that I won't wear knickers to my school. I'm like, no, I need a pair. I can't wear knickers. People will see my legs. Right? I can't wear half an inch. Like, no, I need a full one. People can see my hands. Right? I was there. Still today, I cannot let anyone touch me. I feel awkward. I cannot I'm like, okay, keep a distance, and that's super fine. We can talk very well, but we'll just not do this touching thing. So I don't know why it's there in my brain, but it's there. I don't know whether it's some kind of OCD kind of thing where I have some disease where I feel an infection is there or something like that, but I don't know what.
No, I guess I know the reason for this. I'll tell you later on. At a later point of time, I'll tell you the reason for this.
So I'm like, I don't have anything to say. And I just said, pass on a PC with it now. I told him. And I shifted to the other PC and I opened DisneyChannel.in.
Okay.
Right from the
top. That's so, you know, like, that's so, like, contrasting.
That's me, because at that point of time, 8th class, I am someone who is always locked in the house. What would I do? I watch Harry Potter, I watch, what do we call this, Disney Channel, or I watch some of the big Backboard of Steel kind of a show or a TV show. That's me. That's my max.
Rodi's was your upper limit.
That's the max I can rock. That's it. That's where I end my enthusiasm and my energy. No, bro, this is not my thing. So I went to this. Now what happened, and from there this journey started, that I wanted to go on TV, because I was seeing Disney Channel, I was seeing Bani J, Ran Vijay, Nikhil Chinnappa, Ayushman Khurana, all of these people on TV. They were cool. I'm like, hey, I want to be like these guys. They are cool. Become a VJ. I would listen to radio. Right? So I'm like, RJ, right? That's the thing to do. Because they have a lot of fan following. People love them. People love these guys, right? And they are someone who train people. So I thought I'm going to do that. I took a competition by Disney called Talk Out Loud, and I got disqualified.
Okay.
Cut too short, I came back and some super brainy guy. Like, I think that's kind of like Bhagwan ka chhota sa job that aake aapko kuch beef mein bol kar ke jaate, that's kind of thing. Because I don't know who this guy. And I know this one thing that somebody suggested, that why don't you do one thing? Hack Disney Channel ka website and upload your photo over there as the winner.
Okay.
Right? If I can hack the website and upload my photo as the winner, I'll be the winner. Like, that tiny does not know that just changing the photo does not declare me as the winner. There are real people who sit on a PC and they know, like, some other guy was, how can this guy be the winner? And now if you're the winner, we don't call you to office and say, okay, now do the VJing. If I change the photo over there on the PC. What I do is I go to all the cyber cafes around my house, and at that point of time, cyber cafes were really in trend because internet was really like there. People wanted to be an Orkut. That was the Orkut era. Right? So I went to a few cyber cafes asking them, hey, you know, there's any hacker you know, like who visits around, who can, who know how to hack. So, and luckily I found one guy. There's a very right cafe. So the cyber cafe is called Friendship Cyber Cafe. There anymore, but these two people who run the cyber cafe are very seedha saada guys. They are married from a village to this city with some money in hand from parents to start a cafe and run it very genuinely so that they can go back home, do the puja, and stay with the family and come back and do it. Not the guys usually who we found in the cyber cafe and all of these.
Yeah,
very genuine. They allowed me to sit on that PC for hours and hours throughout the day whenever the PC is free with no money at all.
Okay, wow.
I wouldn't have to pay. So I think ye jo quotation hai na, mujhe sahi lagti hai. Ye bahut hi filmy hai, lekin mujhe lagta hai kaam karti hai. Mere saath to kari hai, which is, kisi cheez ko shiddat se chaho, puri kainat
ko sunna hai. Yeah.
Things do come in place. If you want to do it, things do come in place.
Totally. Right?
मुझे जब सीखना था तो हाउ डिड दीस टू गाइस आई नीड देम वो मुझे फ्री साइबर कैफे पूरे दिन के लिए दे देते थे राइट आई डिड नॉट हैव हैड अ पीसी आई डिड नॉट हैव इंटरनेट कनेक्शन आई डिड नॉट हैव मनी टू गेट वन एंड इट वाज वेरी क्लोज टू माय हाउस सो आई वुड जस्ट वॉक टिल हियर एंड स्टार्ट यूजिंग द पीसी आई वुड जस्ट गो से हाय पंकज भैया हाय अशोक भैया एंड जस्ट सिट ऑन द पीसी एंड यूज इट नाउ टेकिंग इट फॉरवर्ड सो आई मेट दिस गाय कॉल्ड शिशिर असाती He is very humble, very genuine, very polite. If he speaks, he's like he can really remind me of Dalai Lama.
Okay, wow.
So humble, so genuine. He would love me so much. He would treat me like a bhai, right? That knowledge I need, he will help me with it. He would guide me for the right things. And he would stay very low-key, right? I met this guy and he's super knowledgeable, super knowledgeable. Right. Currently, he stays in London.
Okay.
He works for one really big multinational company. I don't want to take name off. He has worked for ones like
me. Got it.
Right? On a very senior designation. And he's into computer security. So I asked him that I want to learn computer hacking and all. That's where the journey started. And taught me a lot of things. I did courses from Cisco, Red Hat, Microsoft, Council, in computer security. To do these courses, I earned money by doing a job on in a company called Tikona. It's a Wi-Fi corporate company. So I would work as a sales guy to go meet my friends and anyone and sell an internet connection. And whatever money I would make, I would use that money to pay the fee courses. I learned that I don't need to hack the website.
Okay.
This knowledge to achieve something better and bigger. From where the journey started, and then, but by the time I wanted to learn more, I realized I do not have money. Right? In 11th class, and now I need a lot of money to study further. To go to college for about 8 to 10 lakh rupees for 4 years.
Yeah.
5 years would be the college fee. 4 to 5 years will be spent on me, my food, my dress, and everything. So my mom is on a job which pays like 9 to 10,000 rupees per month. Right? How would I bring this much money every year to survive. Right? So then college was not an option for me, not an option for my mom to ask me to go to college, because how we will bring, and I was already paying for my this courses. Now I got inspired by Swami Vivekananda. That's when I started this NGO called the Golden Bird Foundation.
Got it.
And if I can't get a computer, I will start an NGO and help other kids do it. Right? The NGO started in 2012, 14th of February. From then on, I started working in this NGO on my own. I asked my mom to come and give her name because I was 15 and a half. I was not legally allowed to have an NGO or anything like that. I asked my mom, two of her friends, to come and be the trustee and let me start it. I started running this NGO, and the NGO did good. I kept pushing. I was the guy who would wear slippers. And I have a bag, and I would travel in a city bus, and I would have a black and white chota sa or a China wala phone call, jo bahut tez hai ya char speaker wala. That from there I started, and I would go here and there, meet people, just walk in a slipper in the office and everywhere. People would mock, like legit people have mocked me. I know the people still today who mock me. And I'm kind of like thankful to them for pushing me through that.
Your critics make you stronger, man. Totally.
Okay, like if they wouldn't have told me, they wouldn't have mocked me, I'd be like, I'm happy, I'm doing so amazing, everyone talks good about me.
Until someone does that, only then you realize ki, okay, there is scope for improvement, where I can improve.
Like if somebody can, there's space to grow, right?
Yeah.
The time required it. Because see, never learn anything from anyone who agrees with you.
Yeah, totally.
Right? If I agree with you, I'm the audience doing this. You do not learn from these people who do this. The one who tell you after the show that, bro, baki sab ka, that was not right. Like, okay, what I learned. Right? So there are a lot of people who mocked me a lot, and I saw that bahar jo log hain bahar, they are not really doing cool. And then I understood that the average value of five people around me is equals to my value.
Yeah, right? Totally.
I started thinking my network that, oh, these are not the people I want around me. I always want to be with people who are, let's say, 10 years elder to me.
So having the proper mentors really goes a long way.
Right? So I became friends with them itself. Ki mujhe aise hi log usse apni. So ye hone laga, and NGO mein kai sare problems aaye, kai sari cheezein maine kari.
Part where you know where you said about critics, it reminded me of a quote by Theodore Roosevelt. I don't know if you have heard it or not. He said once that there are two kinds of people in the world. The first is a reasonable man, and the second is an unreasonable man. So the reasonable man adapts himself to the world, whereas the unreasonable man makes the world or the environment around him adapt to him. So in hindsight, when you look at it, all the change, whichever change happens in the world, it happens because of the unreasonable man. So that was really like, that really resonated with the point that you were saying, bro. So bro, like shifting to a different tangent now, I would like to ask you, what is the most important lesson that you have learned through your travels? If you were to, like, let's say, if you were to, like, just, you know, sum it up in, like, let's say, one paragraph, and that would be all you were able to say to the world about all the travels you have been on, what would that one paragraph be?
I would say this. You can't read it properly because it's mirrored, but it's written, your dreams.
Live your dreams. Got it.
This is what I would say simply, because see, we all gonna die.
Yeah, man. Soon. Totally.
Not long. We think that we have a lot of time.
For
us, because that's all we have seen.
But
in reality, it's a lot of time when we have this, right? And when we die, we won't really think about the cars we had. The homes we had. Or anything. You don't think how much we really enjoyed this one. Right? Just go out and live it.
Totally, bro.
Thinking that I'm gonna do this and then I'll surely do this.
Got it, bro. Got it.
One last. And surely I'm doing this.
Yeah, totally. That happens to so many people.
It will just take one more year. Then I'm doing this.
But you never know if you will be alive at the end of that year.
And it seemed like totally. I'll just do it after this one. You know that you do not like this.
Why are you doing this if you don't like this?
Yes, so I know even after this long, now when I go on a next trip, I do. Right? When I go on hitchhiking trips, just sharing one experience. So maybe hitchhiking trip chalu hone wali, I ask out there, तैयार हो गया मेरा बैकपैक है मैं गैलरी में खड़ा हूँ नानी के घर पे and I'm looking at the road and as soon as I get out of this house and I'm there right on the road today this road will act really different I was out yesterday on this road was different because I'm coming back to this house I know where I'm sleeping I know what I'm eating where I'm eating I'm sorted Right, I know how to get the key of this road back and they will let me come in. Today, now when I get on this road, there is no security, no safety, but a lot of adventure.
Totally. Bro.
Things I don't know of, right? A lot of unknown stories, a lot of unknown people, a lot of experiences. I will never get any other opportunity to have them. Right? And it's really scary. I feel that scared in the heart. Beating fast, my stomach is paining, my throat is already like.
Yeah, but then that nausea when you realize ki death can come to any one of us and it can come at any time, it's kind of super scary. You shit your pants, but then it's also kind of liberating because you realize that you have nothing to lose. It's like, theek hai, like, what's the worst that's going to happen? I'm going to die. That's happening anyways.
Exactly. So that's what I would say that this is what I've learned from travel that see a mountain top every day and go and climb it.
God.
I would do this. I would every morning would wake up and climb the mountain and come back home with my pants ripped apart. So I'm like, yeah, trying to get down and I fall and this is what I did to my pants today.
Got it, man.
So, like, legit, I would fall down the mountain. Where I was living, I would fall down and I would get another one. But I would go and do the mountain. I'd go on the top of the mountain. Like really, as a story, that the gaon ke raja ne baad mein usse baat ki. Wo tumne jo upar 5 baje chadh ke gaana ga rahe the. So village ke saamne wale pahad pe main sirf 5 baje chadh jaunga. And I really love Tomorrowland. I love EDM music. I love Hardwell. I would turn on Hardwell. I would go on the mountain and look at the whole village. And then plays and it's my set and that's my audience.
Oh damn, bro. That's so liberating just thinking about it, bro.
So being on the top of a mountain where you see the cloud is coming from there. And that was the first time when a cloud was coming here to me like this. I was like, shit, will I go with it or what will happen? I have never been like this that I'm standing and I see a mountain, like a cloud coming towards me. I'm like, so what does this do? Like, will it take me away? Will I fall or what should I do? I should have said.
It just passes through you.
I'm like, oh, nothing happened. No. Because I was really scared. But so being there, still, like, find me another guy who had this experience that I was scared from a cloud which was coming my side and I was scared what to do. This experience, find me another guy who has this experience of getting into an accident with a cloud. Me being there on the top of the mountain at morning 6-7 and then this tiny village of Buddhist people in Spiti Valley, me listening to Marvel, pretending this is my set, this is my Tomorrowland, all of these are my crowd, and I'm like, put your fucking hands around that thing over there. And the after a week, the Raja of the Gaon is asking me, so you were the one on the mountain shouting out loud in the morning. The villagers were saying that some guy has gone mad on the top of the mountain. Yeah. And I was just enjoying music. I was like, no, you should not do this. People are concerned about you.
Wow, bro. Like, this is just, that's totally awesome. Just thinking about it. I feel like doing it right now. Truth be told. Genuinely. So that's awesome, man. That part of your life is like really adventurous and like really, inspiring. But what about content writing? So like you have been writing content for quite some time, apparently. You were working at Your Story before, and then now you're working for Forbes. So that's kind of huge. So like, how did that whole thing happen?
So, okay, I would like to correct you. I do not work for any of these companies.
Yeah, sorry, you're a writer, contributing writer, yeah.
So what I do is, I don't write because I have to write or I have an assignment. I write because I have something to share. That's when I write. So I don't like sit every day and write.
Yeah.
I live when I do something or when I end up doing something or when I come across something which is really then at that point of time I take a pad and start writing that okay, let's do this.
Got it. So it isn't like most writers ki every Sunday I should have an article on my desk from you. So no deadline, it's like pretty chill scenes.
Yeah, so it's more like it's an opportunity to communicate.
Got
it. To put something out there for intellectuals to read or to learn or to share. So it's a format to story. It's a format of storytelling in a way, right? So I'm not doing anything. I'm just doing storytelling because I've got so many experiences like today. What we are doing is storytelling in a format of a podcast in audio or in video, right? So that's what I'm saying. वहाँ जो मैं कर रहा हूँ वो एक storytelling है. वो एक बहुत अच्छी story है जिसको बाहर जाना जरूरी है. मुझे लगता है कि मैं नहीं करूँगा तो कोई और भी नहीं करेगा उस part. So that's why my pad and I write it down. And these are different platforms which I use because they cater to different kind of content. They're not all.
So how did this start? Like, how did you get the offer, or like, did you apply for it? Like, how does it work?
So first of all, it all So there's another quote. This one I've written. I don't know whether I've really written or I've read it, and then I believe that I've written. So find it for yourself and let me know if really I've written. I'll be happy enough.
Yeah.
But the quote. In order to be a leader tomorrow, start leading yourself today.
I've heard this somewhere, for sure.
He has already written, right? So what do we call it? So to be a writer tomorrow at someone else's platform, become a writer at your platform first. It's simple. So what I did is that I started this blog, I started writing my own journey, because when I started this cycling thing, and then slowly I understood that okay, I need to travel, I want to travel more. And the first thing when I thought about travel, the first thing came in my mind that hey, travel blogging. Because I have also been in tech.
Yeah.
I know how to make a blog, I know how to make a website, I know how to run. I have run blogs earlier while I was in school. Right? So I can do blogging, that's how I can make money to travel. So that's why I started a blog, I started writing over there. And when this worked out really well, this one point and the second point in this growing in this field is I really have good network.
Yeah,
and
totally.
Because I've been building it for years and years, years and years. More than 10 years that I've been doing. I just told you 2012 I started the NGO. Right?
Yeah.
Even before 2 to 3 years I invested into learning this kind of computer so that I know people from tech. Then I know people all the NGO sector and business and companies who sponsor NGOs who are interested into CSR. Then I got into cycling, I know that side. I was organizing event under the NGO. I know the people who invest into events. Then as a traveler, I got to know a lot of people. So it was very nice. I know the people who own these companies, these publications, right? Or the people who head these publications. So that's why it's very important for me to. And also, like the trust part, which I said with the parents, same applies. Like, they see that I've been writing. I've been writing on my own platform. So for them, when I go and tell them that I want to write on yours, I'm like, okay, do it. And then I go to the next. Not only his, he was writing on that other platform as well. We'll do this.
So that credibility builds up over time.
Yeah, so the ground was my own blog. From the ground, I got one step, then second step, then third one. When I applied to the fifth, he has been already in the board and the ground himself.
To
let him
Understood. Got that, bro. So the last part that I would like to talk to you about is your vegan experience. So that's something which started getting a lot of so-called hype in the last few years. A lot of people have been turning, like, if not vegan, then vegetarian at least. And what was that experience like? Were you always a vegetarian and then you turned vegan, or did you used to have non-veg and then you turned veg and then vegan? So what was that like? And what changes did you notice when you turned vegan totally?
So simple journey, from the childhood to till before the last six years, I have been a vegetarian.
Okay.
Right? When I got to understand climate change, I realized carbon footprint is one thing, which is tiny. The bigger part is me. I decided, how can I lower down my footprint in methane? I learned animal agriculture. Animal agriculture is a culprit over here. I said, okay, let's start. So that came down to zero. And I stopped consuming all the dairy
product. Got it. So what was that experience like physically in your body? Did you feel any changes when you turned totally vegan?
So, like earlier I was super energetic. Still I'm super energetic. Like I don't have any low, I don't have any high.
So like it was a constant thing, like no positive change either, like turning vegan. There are some people who say that they feel a lot more cleaner when they turned vegan. So is that something you experienced?
For me, it still would go the same, because I was not really someone who would always be very about, oh, I need paneer only, and paneer is the only thing I eat. I need butter, otherwise I won't eat. I've always been this very simple guy that whatever you're making, let me know it's ready, I'll come in.
Got it. So you don't exactly have that food like fascination ki nahi mere ko khane ka chahiye aisa.
It's like I do not enjoy food now that this everything is good. So I would crave for everything. I would crave for chocolate. So for me, I want to eat food of every state in every way. Right? When I go to South India, I know that I'm crazy about rice over there. That's what gives me the right taste of the place. When I come to Central India, I know I want to eat chapati. I don't want to have rice over here, because when I go to South,
that's the speciality over there.
So, and I know South and North, I would get the chapati. Center is the only place where I really eat proper chapati.
Yeah.
Right? When I go to North, I know that first I have to be on parathas, Himachal Pradesh. And then when I go on the top, clear. Himachal top everywhere, Ladakh if we talk about now, or else we talk about Spiti Valley. I know I will depend upon more soupy foods or rices. Rice, right? So I'm like, okay, let's just go with it.
So even your food preferences is according to your traveling location, like where you are.
Yeah, exactly.
Damn, bro, so this is like totally fascinating. Like genuinely.
Recently I put up a story that I really want to eat sapad. Sapad is staple Tamil food.
Yeah.
So I miss food as well, time to time. I miss language. I miss people. So yeah. So I eat everything. It just should be vegan now. And for me, it's basic food, and I get enough of energy. And I think for me, it's more of my mental energy, strength that I really want to do it, whatever I'm picking up, and less of is my body right for it. If my brain is right, I know that I'm just pulling.
Got it, bro. Now I have a couple of questions. These are like totally like, you know, fun and chilled out questions. First question is, have you ever related to Bunny from Ye Jawani Hai Diwani? Like, if you have seen that movie?
No. I've seen the movie.
Okay, you've seen the movie. Do you relate to the guy?
I don't relate to the guy. The guy wanted to achieve a lot. He wanted to travel a lot.
Okay.
He wanted to go. He wanted to go fast, never stop, fall and again get up and fall. I want to go back to the mountain and be there and fall. I don't want to go to any other country. I don't want to go to India as well. I just want to be on the Himalaya, that's it.
So you just want to travel. So you're saying that he had an ambition ki mereko travel karke aisa banna hai ya wo karna. So you're like, you were in it for the experience, not for the reward, so-called reward.
He wanted to try a lot of things. Simply. Try a lot. Wherein I've already found my love. My love is in Spiti Valley, Himalayas. I want to be on the mountain. he's super happy to be at the beach, to be in a city, to be anywhere.
Yeah.
No,
so yours is specific. I need a mountain. Yes, got
exactly. It. Because when, see, what really gives me the push, one very simple thing. When I lose my breath, that's when I feel it.
Yeah. There is another quote for this. I'm pretty sure you would have heard this one, that life is not measured in the number of breaths you take. It's measured in the breathtaking moments.
Yeah, exactly. So this is the one. Because see, the reason I love cycling, because when I'm cycling,
it makes you feel breathless. Totally.
That feeling.
Yeah.
When I'm talking, that's what I feel. That any second I can die. The adrenaline rush, the steady.
Yeah, that rush is what you live for.
Because I've been really on mountain edges. Where like, a tiny place, I can't keep even my feet. Right? My feet is, let's say, 10 centimeter. But I've got 5 to 6 centimeters to walk.
Shit.
Right? So being on these places, being in places where I know that, okay, I'm going to die here.
You actually connect with your mortality.
Yeah, because I'm like, okay, this is where you die. So that rush, that feeling, and then you beat it and you come out and be like, oh my God, now tell me. What are the problems you were facing in the life? Right? Like, oh, my body is not working. My this is not working, my that is not working, my life is not going. I'm like, okay, I was just about to die.
Got it. Because it connects with the moment, like in all entirety. So like there's another thing which people do for this, and even I've tried this a couple of times. Like, you know, like once or twice in a year, just attend a funeral. You might not know the person whose funeral it is, you might not know anyone who's, you know, at that funeral. But just attend it. Like, you know, like with the Shamshan Ghat, where they burn the bodies, just go and sit and see the bodies being burned for a day. That's not even for a day. Hell, just see one ritual. It blows your mind. It connects you. That doesn't matter. You will die. You will be burned or buried, depending on your religious inclination. And that's it. You're gone. People will remember you for 10, 20, 30 years if you're very, you know, if you achieved a lot in life. And then you're, that's it. You're in the end, you're back to earth. So it really works that way, man.
I'm going to do it.
Sure, man. Sure.
Like, legit slap you hard.
Yeah, totally, man. It actually reconnects you. Just like, you know, it brings you down. Ki kahan ud raha hai tu? Niche aaja. Kuch nahi hai tu. You know, it gives you that thing. Ki...
What dreams of car are you having in your mind? Come back. We're going to burn you down right
there. Of course, like that's there. I remember, like, I have a mentor, and he, when I was talking to him about public speaking. So initially, I was also afraid. Like when I was 11, 12 years old, I was really afraid of, like, you know, speaking up even in class, because I was afraid that people will judge me and all that stuff. So I asked him, so how did you start public speaking? And like, if someone does not know how to, you know, get good at public speaking, what should they do? So it is like, okay, you're on a stage. Just look at the crowd. Aise dekho pure crowd ko, and just look at them in general and be like, ye sab marne wale. And then just start from there. Because that makes you, you know, remember that there's nothing to lose. Sab to marne wale hain. Kya hi ho jayega? That kind of a thing, bro. So, bro, one question which is really bothering me right now is, how are you, what are you doing right now? Because you're someone who's always out there. And right now, it's like lockdown. So, abhi to chalo, it's still a bit, you know, relaxed. But in the initial 2-3 months, jo the, how did you cope? What did you do in that space?
I nailed it. I've been super productive. I did not let myself go in that place where I feel like, oh, everything is bad. I'm like, okay, the time now, what can you do with it? Because when I go out there on road to travel, there are times when I have to stop by and do something to make something all right so that I can again travel. I'm like, hey, now it's time when I can't really travel. So let's just do that thing now, which I will have to do later on. So rather than sitting and crying that I want to travel right now only, I said, okay, let's do the thing which I anyway have to do, is stay at a place and do it, which is making money, which is making good money, so that I can just travel. Because when I'm traveling, I hate waiting for money and stop by and wait for money. Like, no, I'm not going to do that. If I have to be just one room with a laptop and internet connection, let's just do what best can be done here. I learned more about climate change. I wrote more about climate change. I learned more about my field. How can I do things? I created a lot of connections. I spoke to a lot of people. I thanked all of them who have been there with me to help me, support me, and reach here, right? And I created a lot of presentations. Last night, I did not sleep. That's the reason we responded to 1 hour ahead, right? Day before yesterday night, I did not sleep because I was working on another presentation.
Wow. So you're in full hustle mode right now, despite the lockdown and stuff.
No, who said it's a lockdown? You decide it's a lockdown. I did not decide. I decided it's the, let's say, make money time.
Wow. All a matter of perspective.
If you say you are in a lockdown, then you are in a lockdown. If I say no, that's my travel time. I'm taking this year off. Anyway, if not today, then tomorrow I will take this off.
Mm.
And then make
money. Mm.
So rather than sitting and crying for travel, because I can't get it.
Yeah.
Like I do cry time to time.
Mm.
For that next 20 minutes, I'll watch as many videos of different bloggers who have been to mountains. I'll watch their videos, cry it out, and that's it. Call my friends in the mountain, talk to them. What are you doing? What is happening over there? Can I come? Continuously, I'm trying. Even today, I called my friend Nishita.
Mm.
Right? Let's go back to speaking. Huh? She's like, no, man, we got no kulani. It's not possible to go over there. And anyway, the season is about to end. So going back there now does not make sense. We'll go for the next year on. Right? I try to think, can we go now? Can we go now? Is there any option? But I try for that limited time. Then hang, I checked it. It's not working. Now let's not try. Let's get back and do this thing. Because my idea is this only that up until now, I've enjoyed my life. Hmm. Amazing. I want to enjoy and keep it as well. I don't want to sit that, okay, I do this, then we go for it.
Yeah.
So my anywhere I can move, I'll move from here to mountain, live over there, happy, still work. Work for 2 to 3 years max.
Mm.
Make all the money I want.
Mm.
And I don't need a lot of money.
Got it.
Make the money, put it into the bank, as in whatever this saving thing happens, how can I like keep getting the interest on this money and that whatever thing.
Mm.
I do it and I'm never getting back to work.
Understood. Got that, man. That's awesome, bro. Because like, especially like you are 24 right now and I'm going to turn 20 this year. And like, especially in our age bracket, like you are the age where people usually pass out from college. Most people, like if they're doing a BTEC or a 4 or 5 year degree. So this is the time where people pass out. And like most of my friends, like the people in my college and like other people I know of our age, they're kind of loitering around ki pura Netflix ka catalog khatam kar diya humne baith ke. That's like what we have done. And like, especially seeing someone who's actually working like this so much, that's really awesome, bro. Great. Cheers to you, man.
Because watching Netflix is not really taking me. Like, watching Netflix is just utni rehega maza.
It's a momentarily thing.
Exactly. And see, main ko cheez bataun. Abhi pura pause ho gaya. Pause hai. Right? Okay. Yahan ka pause ho gaya. Thoda नीचे जा रहा है धीरे धीरे, लेकिन एक दिन फिर उठेगा. ये है तुम्हारे कॉम्पिटिटर्स जो तुम्हारी फील्ड में, लेट्स से मेरे लोग ब्लॉगर्स, इंस्टाग्रामर्स, कंटेंट क्रिएटर, एवरीवन. और ये हमारा मार्केट, हम लोग ये यहीं के यहीं है, इनका लॉकडाउन लगा, ये भी धीरे धीरे थोड़े कॉपी हो रहे, नीचे जा रहे हैं. ये मार्केट भी नीचे जा रहा है. क्या होगा, इन्होंने पैसा बचा के रख दिया, ये पॉज पे चलेगा अभी, और ये लोग भी पॉज पे चले गए, कुछ नहीं करेंगे. इनमें से इकलौता एक बंदा है जिसने डिसाइड किया मैं पॉज पे जा ही नहीं रहा.
तो ही विल कम टू द टॉप एंड देन द स्प्रिंग एक्शन विल हैपन एंड व्हेन द इकोनॉमी गोज बैक इनटू फोर्स यू विल पॉप अप.
नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, दीस आर ऑल द क्रिएटर्स एंड एवरीथिंग, दीस आर फ्यू पीपल हु डिसाइडेड टू गो, स्टिल कीप वर्किंग एंड हसलिंग. जैसे आई नो फ्यू पीपल हु आर हसलिंग स्टिल एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. यू चेक आउट प्राजक्ता कोहली. उसने एल्बम भी लॉन्च कर दी थी, राइट? काश मैं सारी चीज बता पाता. और ये सब उसने कर दिया. Everyone is sitting. पॉज हो गया, कुछ नहीं कर सकते. When the market opens up, अब वो किसके पास आएगा?
The people have been working right now.
And जो ऊपर है अभी के लिए, पता नहीं किसने काम करा, आज जो सबसे अच्छा दिख रहा है उसके पास आके करेंगे.
Got it.
So I believe in law of attraction. I believe man can believe and achieve. It can whatever believe and conceive, it can achieve.
Yeah, Napoleon Hill.
How many followers do you see?
Acha, 101k. Yeah.
I don't have 101k.
Yeah, I saw that.
I have 50 around.
Yeah.
Right? So my target is clear. I can't go out and do anything, but I can create content in the house. Like I have so much content, I can edit, I can post it. And I know within the before the time this opens up, what if content creator before lockdown, I was somewhere here. If people were here, now while the lockdown goes off, I'm like here already popping up.
Like this is something I can't show you because like it's stuck on my wall up here. You know the 100k button that you get when you cross 100k subs on YouTube? So right now I have 162. That's it. 162 subscriber. 161 or 162 as of right now. I printed one silver key ka button. Like I first downloaded it. I edited the name at the top and I've stuck it right here. Just so that I look at it. Ki congratulations on 100 subs.
See, that's what dreamers are. See, aap Netflix dekh lo, jitni dekhni hai dekh lo, but you're not living a dream, bro. I'm telling you.
Totally.
The business they sold you. You did not buy Netflix.
Yeah.
They sold you. You did not win. They won. They are not making money.
Exactly.
You are a dream. Jisko banane mein, isko dekhne se bahut zyada maze aaye the. Right? What about this money heist?
Yeah.
मजा नहीं आ रहा जितने भी लोगों को बनाने में आया था.
And like, there's nothing wrong. Like, what I believe is that ki it's okay. Tumhe dekhna hai, tum dekho, watch it. Even that's cool because see, it's like ki for you, travel motivates you. For me, talking to people motivates me. There are some people who genuinely like doing that. So if you're someone who really is into acting, so I have a friend, he's deep into acting. So when I go to watch a movie with him, he doesn't watch it ki entertainment ho raha hai. He watches it to see the artist's like skill set. So if you're obsessed in that manner, do that. And even if you're just watching it for entertainment, do it in moderation. Don't do it ki tum din ke matlab tum 16 ghante jaage ho to 16 ghante mein tum 10 ghante Netflix dekh rahe ho. That doesn't make sense.
Usme hoga ye ki simply then at the end of it all you won't be happy with your life.
Totally. At the end of totally.
Cursing other people for not making things happen, right? You'll be telling people that hey, opportunity. और लक काम नहीं कर रहा है और उसने अपने बेटे को वो चांस दिया और मैं टैलेंटेड बंदा हूं मुझे वो चांस नहीं मिला. यू वोंट गेट द कार यू जस्ट कीप लुकिंग एट द पीपल. यार इसका तो काम ही कुछ गलत है, पता नहीं कैसे ट्रैवल करता है पूरी दुनिया. आई थिंक पता नहीं कैरी करता होगा. आई देन यू डू इट.
टोटली. लाइक वन थिंग दैट आई हैव नोटिस्ड स्पेशली विद लाइक यू नो द ट्रोल्स एंड the negative kind of haters. There are two kind of critics, right? One is the critic who criticizes you to make you improve. And there is another critic who is just like, ki, mere ko karna hai, toh main kar raha hun. And one thing that I have realized is that the other kind of critic who is just there to criticize for the sake of it, when they criticize you, you realize more often than not, it is some...
It's my story.
Okay, I'll just read it out for the people who will listen to this on audio. Constantly seek criticism. A well thought out critique of what you are doing is as valuable as gold. True, bro. Totally true.
Like, and it's my 24 hour Instagram story. So whatever we are speaking, and I did not know that we're going to be on this point in speaking these things. Right?
So totally.
It goes in the brain. Right? That's what exactly like the life is all about. That being constantly trying to get up and do things and achieve things. So, yeah, that's what I would suggest people that, hey, you have a dream, live that, work for it. And this is the time. So, lockdown, agar band hai, toh, just go get the thing done, get it ready. You want to shoot a documentary? Get everything ready for it. So that when it opens up, you're ready to just go and shoot.
Yeah, totally. Puri planning pehle kar lo. Like, be totally prepared for it.
So, at least when the lockdown opens, then you won't sit and now make a script and team and presentation. To people, do it right now because when it's opening up, you have the budget just to go out there and do it.
Got it, bro. Got it. Totally. Right? And like one thing about the critic part that I was telling you, I'm pretty sure you will also relate with this. Like if let's say someone criticizes you over something, and if you go and check out their profile, you realize like, let's say someone criticized you for, I'm just taking a random example, or like, don't mind this, but let's say someone criticized you because of your skin color, that you are a bit dark. And when you go and see their profile, there's a huge chance that that person is dark himself.
Yeah.
There'll be a huge chance. Well, yeah. Like for me personally, it is because I often get criticized because of my English or because of my accent. I know it's a bit different because like I was outside India for 6 years and I've stayed in various places. So matlab khichdi type accent ho gaya. It isn't one specific place.
I speak like more like a Mumbai. I go to South India and I start sounding like a South Indian.
Why? So that happens with travel, right? You like adapt that place ka thoda sa accent and there are certain words where you'll sound a certain accent.
I don't understand. Like I'll just... Really, yeah, really. You're saying that, huh? Really? Mm. So it's going towards the South Indian side of the English, then yeah. It switches right.
So that happens, right? So, but like when people are criticizing me over on the net, and like I'm talking about the people, so I have a very small following right now. So I've gotten like 3-4 times when I've been criticized for this thing. And when I check out their thing, I realize ki these are people who are not comfortable in speaking up. Be it English or Hindi or like whatever language they're using, they are just not comfortable in speaking up. And it is that insecurity which is getting projected onto me, which they're trying to throw off to me. Like that's what I have noticed.
And very simple. See, if there is someone who really want to give you a suggestion to help you and improve, they would drop a very polite and a very happy message. That, hey, I love you, think what you're doing. It's just, I thought one thing, a point if I can mention, and this might help you. Like, why don't you try taking care when you're saying that word? If you speak it properly, it will come out really nice. That's it. And rest is everything fine. I really love your work. Keep going. So that's how somebody will come and really give you a suggestion if they really want to improve you.
Yeah.
Totally. Else, if there's any other way people are telling you, forget it. They are not really telling you to grow. They are telling you to mock you.
Yeah.
Right? And, hey, I don't need. I am not really looking for people to come and mock me up.
Totally, bro. Totally. Right? Bro, one last question, like in the funnier aspect, and then we'll be done for this episode, is you have traveled all across the globe. Which is your favorite location? If you were to choose one location where, if I tell you today, okay, now there's a restriction, you can only go to one location and that's it.
Okay.
Which location? Sorry?
I'll just go to Piti Valley.
Okay, where is this exactly?
Piti Valley is at the border of Himachal Pradesh and shares border with China.
Okay.
We are like Himachal ka border, sharing a border with Ladakh and here inside with China. That's okay. Where it is. It's this village. It's a Buddhist valley. Not a village.
Okay. The village you're talking about right now, where you went up to the top of the mountain. Okay. Wow. That sounded like very beautiful. Like, when you were describing it.
Super beautiful, super beautiful. You won't believe this kind of a place exists. It's like a hidden treasure over there. You can't see it from the outside. You take different turns. Somewhere in between, you reach over there and you realize, shit, in between all of these mountains, there's one tiny village which looks like dream.
Damn, this sounds like an adaptation from Kung Fu Panda, one of the movies. There is a village like this there. Like, it's hidden in the mountains. You can't see it. And then you just suddenly see it out of the blue.
It's a beautiful place. Very less people. I live over there every year for 101 days. Work on different okay, projects. Wow. Everyone knows me over there by name. I know people there by name. Even if somebody is traveling to there and shoots a video and put it on YouTube, I'll make, in that video, that shot, if you turn it a little around, that the other house, that's of my friend Takpa. He lives over there. Oh, that's a house of so I know people really well over there. That's really what connects me to that place, because people are very genuine, very happy, and the sole focus is about being happy, happiness, and feeling satisfied, minimal lifestyle.
Got it, bro. Last question would be, what would you say to someone who's like, let's say 19 right now, someone who wants to start traveling, he hasn't started exploring yet, he knows that he has a passion for traveling, but he doesn't exactly know how to start, What should he do?
More simple, I would say that try different things, tiny. Let's say if you live in, which city are you in currently?
I'm right now in Prayagraj because my dad is posted here.
Cool. So let's say if you're in Prayagraj and you're 19 and you live over there, try a few different things. Get out of a house for one day and take, let's say, 200 rupees or 300 rupees and decide a place where you will go and come back. So leave in the morning from Prayagraj, go to that place, eat something over there, travel a little, talk to a few people, visit a temple or any place over there, come back by the evening, go back to your home.
Got it. So like start within your reach and then expand from there on.
Right? So you will get experiences of a few things and you'll already be ready to push a little more further next time.
Right? Got it, bro.
Hitchhiking. Now once you have done budget traveling, then try hitchhiking. Try going to bus and talk to the bus wala or a gaadi wala for a lift and go to one place to another. Don't go far. Go nearby. In your own city, get out for a day, decide five places you want to go, travel and come back home without money, without any vehicle. Take lifts and go and come back.
Got it, bro. Got it. Thanks a lot for being here. It really meant a lot. And definitely, like, this was more like, you know, a big brother to a younger brother kind of conversation, because most of the people I bring on are like 10, 20, 30 years older than me. And you're someone who's only like 5 years older than me. So it was a really nice, a different kind of a conversation, bro. So thanks a lot for being here. It really means a lot, man. And I hope we do this sometime again with another topic, something else. So thanks a lot for that. As for the audience, like this, go check out Akash's page, his blog. I'll link everything down in the description. Check all that out and keep supporting us. Thanks. Thank you, Akash.